Whangarei was the first place in New Zealand to have ultra-fast broadband delivered, and Benaia View School was obviously the first school and the first organisation to have ultra-fast broadband. Minister Stephen Joyce, he launched the project here in December 2010, and we were very privileged to be the school and the organisation chosen. To get the best service deal, I clustered with four other schools, and by doing that we were able to get the best price and we were able to get the right services that we needed. Once North Power Fibre had built past these schools and they'd had their service lines put in, the network could go live and all we had to do was find a retailer. We worked out our needs, negotiated as a team and struck a deal with Orcon in July 2011. By September 2011, all the schools in the group were connected. We chose a package with speeds of 50 megabits per second up and down from the internet, a 20 gigabyte international data cap, and free domestic data.
Leanne, you're three terms in now to this. How did you go about it?
At the beginning, when we got the ultra-fast broadband in, I was very concerned about my lack of knowledge and understanding about how we were going to work through the process to getting a retail provider to put the service in place in the schools. My advice would be to cluster with other schools in your region and to use the support documentation that's on the TKI site to work through needs analysis of your school and having the assistance of the other principals in the other schools to work your way through understanding and identifying what the needs are. Because it's one thing to know what you need and there's another thing to say, well, I'd like to be able to do, what's that called? What would I need to have in order to get the outcome?
So after having done that needs analysis, what was the next step?
As a cluster, we then decided what was required, so some specifications of exactly what we needed to identify in our contract with our RSP. You know, there was a perception out there that this was going to cost a lot of money, so we were concerned about that. We went into the negotiations with a firm idea that we were not going to pay more than 20% over that, you know, price that we'd originally been paying. So that set the parameters for us as a group. There were huge differences in the tender prices that we received, and so that made it quite difficult at first because we were unsure as to whether or not we were actually comparing apples with apples. But once we realised we were, then it was quite clear that we were looking for, you know, the best price.
You were able to negotiate free national traffic. Tell me about that.
Mm. Well, that makes a huge difference. I mean, we were using up to, you know, anywhere between 60 to 80, you know, gigabytes a month and quite often going over, and that was by copper. And when we went into the ultra-fast broadband, we originally started with 20 gigabytes because that's all we needed because most of our traffic was national traffic.
Have you seen any cost savings as a result of the deal?
Yeah, we've noticed cost savings in so many different areas in school. We've gone from double figures to single figures in terms of our photocopying. So there's no need for, you know, large numbers of resource books around a particular topic because they can be downloaded and, you know, they're online.
You must get calls from teachers and principals about your experience all the time. In a nutshell, what advice would you give to other schools?
Well, I think that the first thing is that you have to make an informed decision. You know, you are being held responsible for making quite a big decision around budgeting for your school. It also is about what the future needs and direction of a school. If at all possible, I would cluster with other principals so that you could talk through some of the issues or some of the specs that you may perhaps not be au fait with at the moment and need clarification on. There certainly is still, I believe, buying power when you cluster as a group. So that would be my advice. Make sure you're well informed before making your decisions.